Alright, let's get into it. This is Henny Honky from DatWave.com, NaturalNativeFilms.com. Go to DatWave.com for all your hip-hop news and lifestyle needs. Today we're going to be talking about O.J. Simpson's parole hearing, of course. R. Kelly's holding bitches hostage in a cult. And Usher is apparently letting it burn. Let's get into it.
Do you like teenage girls?
When you say teenage, how are we talking?
Girls who are teenage.
All right, man, we all know age ain't nothing but a number. Thank you, R. Kelly, for writing that song for Aaliyah. R.I.P. to Aaliyah. And we also know cults are where the fuck it's at. Sex cults, to be exact. Can I get an invite, Kells? Just kidding. He's apparently got women captive from the age of 18 to 26. These women may or may not be trapped in the closet, excuse me. He records these sex acts and shows them to his friends, which is a little weird because when his male friends are in the house, he makes these women wear baggy track suits and face the wall, which is pretty damn cool because I need that type of control in my life. He controls their phones. He controls their social media. He doesn't let them contact their family members. Here's a little clip of one of the family members of one of the women that are apparently in the cult being held captive.
My daughter was off in college at the time, and I haven't seen her since. I want to thank y'all for coming out, and I'm going to let someone else speak. I'm going to let my wife speak. And then I'm also going to let Shante speak if she want to.
Can you tell us your name first?
My name is Timothy Savage.
Tim, before you leave the microphone, though, can we ask you, it's a pretty serious charge to say that your daughter's being held against her will. How old is she, and what evidence do you have she's being held against her will?
My daughter
may or may not be a thought.
Right now, she's 21 at this time.
I had an encounter with R. Kelly, and I lived with him at another location that's not far from here. I've participated and witnessed a lot of acts that I did not agree with, and the way he manipulates each and every woman that comes around. I'm blessed to have a strong will mind, and the things that I've witnessed, I have a 17-year-old daughter myself, and I always thought this could be my daughter. I've been reading the blogs. Everybody's saying that, oh, we're lying. R. Kelly's not this monster. He's not that person. I've always been a fan of R. Kelly from day one. I was always defending him until I got behind closed doors. I've reached out to the Savages.
All right, you heard it from the groupie's mouth herself. She's bringing the fucking Savages out, man. And no, not the usual Savages with the 30s, AKs, and all that other shit, knocking out goofies left and right. We talking about the family members of one of the girls supposedly being held at the cult. You know, R. Kelly's got a little bit of a checkered past, for lack of better words. You know, he was accused of pissing in his 14-year-old goddaughter's mouth on camera. He allegedly married Aaliyah at the age of 15. He met her when she was 12. We all know about their rumored relationship. For you new millennials who don't know about this shit, just Google it up and you'll find it real quick. That's why we got the internet, baby. Be progressive. Don't be in the past, little hoes. But let's talk about this other shit, man. We got Usher, man, letting it fucking burn.
Hello? Yo, I'm in the booth. I'm gonna call you right back. Nah, I just gotta put this one part down. I'm gonna call you back. I'm at the studio, man.
Dude, I don't give a fuck that you're in the studio. Get in the fucking hospital.
Man, no, for real. Don't play like that.
Nah, you fucking got herpes, you stupid bitch.
Are you serious?
Well, right, in some other news, we apparently got Usher actually burning bitches. He was diagnosed in 2009, 2010, right around the time he divorced his wife, Tamika Foster. He's been paying millions to women trying to keep down that he has this virus. Could you imagine, man? This Usher got a herpes bill. Like, he ain't got a Ferrari bill, electric bill like most of us. He got a herpes bill. He gotta pay these bitches a herpes bill. Well, as they extort him out this herpes, we got a woman coming forward telling everybody, hey man, he burnt the fuck out of me. This woman said he had a green discharge coming out of his penis, and he just told her that he went to the doctor and he got checked and it was all clear. 2 weeks later, she had sores in her vagina, fevers and chills, and the doctor of course said, bitch, you got herpes. Now, word to my bitches out there, if a man has anything coming out of his penis, you should probably chalk it up that night, you know? Go back on Instagram and slide into someone else's DMs, because you just got some herpes, bitch.
and it will become a public record. So based on all of that, Mr. Simpson, I do vote to grant parole when eligible.
Yeah, you fucking heard it. O.J. Simpson's back, motherfucker. Currently 2-0 on both of his fucking cases. Didn't need to fuck a Kardashian this time. Didn't need fucking Johnny Cochran. He didn't need none of that. Because he was innocent, man. He was trying to take his own memorabilia back. After he was arrested, and mind you, he's been arrested for 9 years. He's been in jail for 9 years for stealing his own memorabilia back, which the court ruled his after he was arrested. But anyway, you know, he's 2-0. He's 2-0. He's feeling pretty good. Jay-Z better be hiding wherever the fuck he's at under his Rockefeller desk or whatever he's doing, because OJ's probably coming for that neck for real.
Gunpoint by O.J. Simpson. Can you send police here, please?
And he said, Bruce, I can't tell you how sorry I am. And we've got a saying between us, it is what it is. And he put his hand out. I shook his hand, and I said, I forgive you. We all make mistakes. O.J. made his. He's been here. And from what I've told, he's been a model inmate. He's been an example to others. During the trial, I recommended that he serve 1 to 3 years. That's what I recommended to the DA.
All right, as you could hear from the snitch, I mean the victim himself, man, he didn't want OJ to get all that time. I probably guarantee he kind of knew it was a misunderstanding from the jump. He was trying to recommend that OJ get 1 to 3 years. I don't know when the fuck victims get to choose the years and recommend them. That must be some new shit that I ain't ever heard in the legal system. I don't know. But OJ got football numbers thrown at him. No pun intended. He's done 9 years so far. He'll get out at his next parole hearing. That's a little too much for trying to get your own shit back. I wish he would have, like, pistol whipped all of his teeth out and, like, made him blind or something, because that would have been like, that would have been cool with me. I think that would have been cool for me for stealing my memorabilia and trying to sell it off when you've probably already made a lot of money off past shit already. But you know, man, this is Henny Honky. Make sure you visit datwave.com for all your hip-hop needs, all your news, everything, lifestyle, fashion, whatever you need. Go to datwave.com. and if you want to check up on me, go to naturalnativefilms.com. that's where I upload all my videos, everything else that has to do with me. Henny Honky, datwave.com. We out.